sahanavavato sahano bhunakto sahavijyam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Om namo narayanaya. Om namo narayanaya. Sadashiva-samārambhāṁ Shankarācārya-madhyamāṁ Asmadācārya-paryantāṁ Vande Guru-paramparāṁ Shruti-smriti-purānānāṁ Ālayam Karunālayam Namāmi Bhagavat-pādam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vandi Bhagavanto Punapunaha Samasta Jana Kalyani Niratam Karunamayam Namāmi Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurthye Namaha Dakshinamurthye Namaha Vishvam Darpana Drashyamana Nagari Tulyam Nijantargatam Pashyan Atmani Mayaya Bahirivot Bhutam Yathanidraya Yes, sakshat kurute prabodha samaye svatmaname vadvayam tasmai shri guru murtaye nama idam shri dakshinamurtaye bijasyantarivankuro jagadidam Pranirvikalpam punaha Maya kalpita desha kala kalana Vaichitra chitri kratam Maya viva vijrambhayatyapi maha Yogi vayasvechaya Tasmai Shri Guru Murtaye Nama Idam Shri Dakshinamurtaye Yasivaspuranam Sadatmakamasat Kalpartakam Bhasate Sakshatatvamasiti Veda Vachasa Yobodhayatyashritan Yes, sakshat karanad bhavena punara vrittir maham bhunidhau tasmai shri guru murtaye nama idam shri dakshinamurtaye nana chidrakatodarasthita maha deepa Prabhabhasvaram Jnanam yasyatu chakshuradikarna Dvara bahispandate Jnanamiti Anubhatye tat samastam jagat Tasmai shri guru murtaye nama idam Shri Dakshinamurtaye Deham pranam apindriyanyapi chalam Buddhim cha shunyam viduh Strī balandha jadopamastvahamiti Bhranta bhrisham vadinah Maya shakti Vilasa kalpita maha Vyamoha samharine Tasmai shri guru murtaye nama idam Shri dakshinamurtaye
After having analyzed the nature of the self as sat and chit. Now the topic is in what all ways this self can be misunderstood. And why do we misunderstand the self? What are the ways in which self can be misunderstood? Why do we misunderstand the self? And therefore the glory of the Guru who gives us the right understanding by removing all misunderstandings. So, Samharine Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Prostrations unto that Dakshinamurti who is the destroyer. Destroyer of what? Mahavyamoham, great delusion. How is it? How has it come? Kalpita, created by Vilasa, sport of Maya Shakti, the power of Maya. Delusion created by the power of Maya. So what is the expression of this delusion? Expression of this delusion is misunderstanding regarding the self, wrong notions regarding the self. What are the different types of wrong notion? Deham, aham, iti. Pranam, aham, iti. Indriyani, aham, iti. Chalam buddhim aham iti. So these are all different wrong notions. All these wrong notions can be together also, one at a time also, or a mix also, in different proportions, different intensities. So chalam buddhim, shunyam, these are all different. So how many types are mentioned here? Deham, pranam, indriyani, chalam buddhim and shunyam. Five different types are mentioned here. Right, so each one we had already seen. Deham means the physical body. In fact, that is the main thing. Misunderstanding that I am the body. Pranam, I am the pranas. Now what does prana mean? See, prana always means a power. Prana doesn't mean breathing. Breathing is one expression of that power. Right? That prana shakti manifests as breathing. That is one. So prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. These are all the expressions of prana. Digestion. It is an expression of samana vayu. Right? So there is a power. That power expresses in different ways. Like for example, electricity is a power. So it can express as rotation of the fan or the light. These are all expressions. So breathing is an expression of prana, right? Generally we think prana means breathing. No. It's an expression. Just like rotating fan is not electricity. Rotation of fan is only expression of electricity. Right. So, deham, pranam, indriyani. When our entire attention is upon the sense organs, when we give too much attention, too much importance to sense organs, then there is nothing wrong in saying, I am sense organs. Right. Just like a mother who is extremely attached to the child, for that mother, what is the feeling? I am the child. Isn't it? Too much of importance and attachment, what happens? The sat in you gets transferred. So too much of attachment to sense organs. Attachment means what? Importance. Whatever is seen, it is absolutely true. Whatever is heard is absolutely true. Then what happens? Your sat gets transferred into what is seen, what is heard. That is called as aham indriyani. This way you have to understand. Otherwise nobody says that I am my eyes, I am my ears. Nobody says. Okay. Chalam buddhim. So what is chalam buddhim? Wrong understanding about consciousness. That it is kshanika. Every moment this consciousness changes. Moment to moment. It is not eternal. There is change happening in consciousness also. So this kind of wrong notion. Chalam buddhi. Shunyam. Shunyam is what? That there is nothing. So it is said that the Shunyavadis defeated all of them and came to the top. So now in the next verse you will find Bhagwan Shankaracharya need not defeat others because they have been defeated. Bhagwan Shankaracharya only has to defeat the Shunyavadi because he is the finalist, you know. That's what is done in the next verse. That will come later. Right. So these are all, what does Bhagwan say? Brishamvadinah. They are all the people who vehemently argue. They are all totally deluded. Brantah. Those people who have Branti, Brahma, is called Brantah. Deluded ones. Not knowing the reality. So what are the possible reasons why we are not able to see the truth? So this we have to understand. Why are we not able to perceive the truth as it is? What are the obstructions? So these obstructions are mentioned by these terms. Stri, Bala, Andha, Jada, Upamaha. Upama means compared to them. So these deluded ones are comparable to these people. So every term is an indication of a defect of the mind. So we'll take up the first one. What is that? Stri. So as we said earlier, Stri has nothing to do with body, because we are talking about a defect of the mind. We are not talking about the defect of the body. Right. So what is what you call generally a feminine mind? A mind which is overpowered by emotions. This generally we see in woman, but not necessarily. A mind which is overpowered by emotion. It can happen in a man also. Then in this context he will have to be called a Stri. Right. In fact, when Arjuna was crying in the battlefield, Bhagwan calls him Klaibyam, isn't it? Eunuch, neither man nor woman. Externally, like a warrior he had come, like a man, but internally he was like a woman crying. Why did that crying came out? He saw his near and dear ones. Suddenly he remembered his attachment, his emotion. So his emotions overpowered his reason. This is what happens. Always the emotion should back the reason. It should not overpower the reason. Reasoning alone should be in front. Emotion should be at the back. Emotion should support the reason. Why? Manasastu para buddhihi. Higher than mind is intellect. So therefore mind should obey the intellect. So if the mind is overpowering the intellect, then there is going to be a problem. What is the problem? Intellect shows you what is the truth. Intellect shows you what is right, what is wrong. Right? What is the duty of the mind? Mind's duty is to like what is right and to dislike what is wrong. So intellect is showing, mind's job is this. Okay, if this is right, then I like it. Then what happens? The mind then gets integrated with the intellect. Liking what is right, not liking what is wrong, then we say mind and intellect are integrated. There will not be any problem in such a person. Everything will be smooth. Such a personality is called integrated personality, where the mind and intellect are one. How do you define it? Whatever intellect says that it is right, mind like doing it. Mind supports it. In a personality, if this is there, there is absolutely no problem. The intellect will show the path of righteousness. The mind will fully back the intellect in walking the path of righteousness. There won't be any problem. There is no friction. There is no tug of war. Otherwise, what happens? Intellect says something is right, mind says I don't like it, then it's a problem. Right. So a feminine mind, we can say, Stri, means what? Where emotions rule. What happens when the emotions rule? Intellect is a slave of the mind. What happens when intellect becomes a slave of the mind? Whatever the mind likes, intellect justifies it as right. Understood? Whatever the mind likes, intellect will justify. That is very dangerous. Because there can be something wrong which the mind is liking. The intellect will obey the mind and say, yes, now that if you like it, fine. I will find out reasons to prove that it is right. Intellect then becomes a slave. All the drug addicts, chain smokers, drunkards, this has happened in them. Somewhere they justify what they are doing. And then they get the permission from their intellect and do. And finally they ruin their life. People who deviate from the path of righteousness, people who yield to all temptations, everywhere this has happened. What has happened? Mind liked something extremely. Now intellect is the signing authority. So intellect signs because there is a pressure from the mind to sign. See, unless intellect says yes, you can't do anything. Because intellect is higher. So the mind forces the intellect and gets the permission. In the presence of such a mind, the intellect becomes paralyzed. Such a paralyzed intellect cannot see the truth. Because it is not free. If you want to see the truth, intellect is the one who is seeing the truth. It should be unbiased, unaffected by the likes and dislikes. The intellect must be unaffected by attachments. Only such an intellect will be a clear intellect. Only in such a clear intellect, truth will be seen. During Shravanam, when you are listening to the scriptures, right, the knowledge is gained by the intellect. But suppose your mind is filled with raga dvesha, then what will happen? The listening becomes selective listening. What I like, I hear. What I don't like, I ignore. Then will you gain proper knowledge? No. So many things are filtered out. You are just tuned to what you like to hear. Right? Selective listening, that is called as partial listening. Therefore, improper listening. Therefore, the knowledge also will be defective. In the same way, analysis, mananam has to be done. You have to analyze. You have gained the data from the world. That data is a faulty data because there has been selective use of your sense organs. So therefore the data is faulty. With the faulty data you analyze. And this analysis also is done by a paralyzed intellect, affected strongly by the likes and dislikes. So naturally, finally, what will be the end product of your analysis? Faulty knowledge, faulty conclusions, right? So that is why Strī, this term has been used. So if your emotions are ruling your reason, then that is a defect of the mind. What is the way to win over this defect? If suppose we understand that there is such a defect in us, there should be some way, isn't it, to overcome. The way is, whatever is right, do it. Whether you like it or not, do it. Every time you listen to the intellect and obey his instructions, the guidance, the intellect starts becoming stronger. Today, why is it that the mind is stronger in us? Emotions are ruling the reason why. It is so because we have always listened to the mind and never listened to the intellect. When we don't listen to intellect, intellect becomes weak. Whatever you listen to, that becomes stronger. So all of us, we have this choice. In every moment there is a choice. Generally these paths are called the path of Shreyas and the path of Prayas. Intellect shows you the path of Shreyas. Mind shows you the path of Prayas. Mind shows you the path which you like. Intellect shows you the path which is right. Every time what you have to do, whatever is right, it has to be strictly followed with iron will. Then slowly what happens, there's a transformation that will happen in you. Slowly the intellect becomes stronger and stronger. Intellect is the light which shows you the path. It's like a torchlight. So as the intellect becomes stronger, that torch light also becomes bright, brilliant. And in that torch light, we very clearly see what is right, what is wrong. The intellect slowly becomes more and more subtle. And subtler the intellect, subtler is your ability to solve problems in life. Because every problem has to be solved through discrimination. What is discrimination? This is right, this is wrong. This I should do, this I should not do. There has to be clarity. What kind of clarity? There should not be any gray areas. There should be a black and white clarity. What is gray area? You are not sure whether it is right or wrong. Such area should be minimum. So as you slowly, slowly listen to your intellect, firmly implementing what you have considered right, whatever you feel it is right, later on it may be proved wrong, which that is okay. But at that moment, if you have felt that something is right, just do it. In the process what happens, there is a willpower also. That willpower also develops. I have to get up early in the morning. Now you are convinced that this is right. Early in the morning getting up is good. Do it! When the alarm rings, the mind will say, no, no, let me sleep for another 5. Don't listen to that mind. Listening to that mind has taken me to this present degenerated state. No more listening. Now see, the whole thing is an internal struggle, you see. It is not external, it's all internal. As I said, dharma kshetre, kurukshetre. Where is this kurukshetra? Not outside, it's inside. This struggle, others are not knowing, only you know. Others are only your coated, suited, booted personality. Inside there is a struggling personality. This only you know. You see? So this way, when you start taking decisions, intellect becomes stronger. Intellect becomes powerful. Intellect becomes bright, brilliant. Such an intellect is very clearly able to take you through the path of truth, through the path of righteousness, and that intellect becomes a perfect charioteer in taking you to the kingdom of the self, to liberation. That is what that simile of that chariot is. Atmanam rathinam viddhi
Shariram rathamevato Buddhim tu sarathim vidhi Manah pragrahamevacha Indriyani hayanahu Vishayan steshu gocharan Atmendriya mano yuktam Bhoktetyahur manishinah
Kathopanishad
Atmanam rathinam vithi.
There is a chariot. And who is the Jivatma? He is the traveler in this chariot. So we are all travelers in a chariot. What is the chariot? Shariram rathamevatu. This body is the chariot. So in the chariot, you need a charioteer also. Who is the charioteer? Buddhim tu sarathim vidhi. The charioteer is the intellect. See, the most important role in a chariot is that of charioteer. He will decide the result of everything. Most important. Reins, what are they? Manaha pragrahamevacha, reins, they are the mind. Indriyani hayan ahu, the sense organs are the horses. Vishayan steshu gocharan, there is a road upon which the horses have to run. What is the road? Vishayan, sense organs. Sense objects. Right. So now the most important role is that of a charioteer. He must know about the chariot. He must know about these horses. He must have tamed these horses. He must also know the destination. He must know the route. There are so many routes. Easy route, difficult route, good route, bad route. He must have the knowledge. Knowledge is everything. Right.
Yastu vijnanavan bhavati samanaskas sada shuchihi. Tasyendriyani vashyani sadashwa ivasarathehe.
A person who has this right knowledge, intellect, very, what you call? Knowledgeable, strong, capable. Such a person will have his mind under control. Just like an efficient charioteer has the reins under his control. Sat ashva iva sarathehe. What about the horses then? When the reins are totally under your control, horses also, they are under your control. When the horses are under your control, what will happen? You reach the destination safely. Right. So how to have an excellent charioteer? Who is the charioteer of Arjuna? Bhagavan. You see, the role of Bhagavan is of that of intellect. So in all of us this intellect is there. It has infinite potential, but we will have to bring out this potential. How to bring out the potential of this intellect? Tapas. What is tapas? Doing the right thing, not doing what you like. That is tapas. Tapas means what? That which generates tapa, heat. Heat means what? Struggle. There is a struggle. Intellect will tell you, this is Shreyomarga, do it. Do it. It is a silent struggle. It's an unknown struggle. A struggle with yourself. A struggle in yourself where the higher is struggling to be free from the clutches of the lower. A struggle. And what will be the outcome of this struggle? Who will decide? It is neither the intellect nor the mind. You have to decide. whom you have to empower. Whether to empower the intellect or to empower the mind. You are the decider. Right. So then, when you constantly listen to the intellect, this particular problem will not affect you. What problem? The three aspect of problem. Emotions overpowering you. It will not happen. Because emotions become humble, obedient servant of reason. We are not criticizing emotion here, please. Emotions have their place. Right? But those emotions should always be guided by reason. This is what we are saying. We are not criticizing emotion. There are noble emotions. It must be cultivated. Emotion should not hijack reason. That's all what we are saying. Because the truth has to be appreciated only by the intellect. It can be appreciated because intellect is an instrument designed for that, to know the truth. It gets blurred. The vision becomes blurred when the mind doesn't cooperate with the intellect. Right. Is it clear? Clear. So Strī is over. Strī. Balan. Bala. Rather. Bala. Strī. Bala. Bala means what? Bala means a child. So here, childish, immature people. Who are they? They are the beginners. Beginners in spirituality. Who are these beginners? They make a lot of noise. They read something from here, something from there, and they misunderstand that information equal to knowledge. Just because you have collected some information here and there doesn't make you knowledgeable. What is the expression of such people who have misunderstood information as knowledge? They talk too much, as though they know everything. Bala. Brishambadinaha. They vehemently argue. The more and more you become knowledgeable, the more and more you become heavy, the more and more you become heavy, lesser the noise. As they say, you know, pot which is full, never make noise. Half filled pot, they make a lot of noise. So in the same way, as you become more knowledgeable, you are silent. Why you are silent? You are silent because your senses are disciplined. Why your senses are disciplined? Because your mind is disciplined. Why the mind is disciplined? Because the intellect is controlling it. Why the intellect is controlling it? Because the intellect is rooted in the reality. So the people who are rooted in the reality, people who are really wise, they are silent also. They have mastery over their organ of speech. When to speak, how much to speak, where to speak, where not to speak. You understand? Brishamvadinaha doesn't happen there. Unnecessarily arguing. What will the Mahatmas do when somebody comes who unnecessarily argues? Mahatmas are silent. They are silent not because they don't have arguments. They are silent because there is no point in putting sense to this fellow, because he is a man with a closed mind. People who are closed, who are not open-minded, not ready to change, not ready to correct themselves, not ready to accept their faults and mistakes, in front of them, Mahatmas are silent. Their silence should not be misunderstood, their weakness or ignorance. Their silence is a matured silence. It's a silence of wisdom. Right? Balaha. Immature people. So in the beginning stages, now these are all the mistakes we may commit. The point is not somebody, eh? Somebody is Bala. No, no, I am the one. Always the accusing finger should be towards ourselves. Am I the one? Should be the question. Am I the one? Childish, immature. Studied something here, there. Listened something here, there. And giving discourses after discourses. As though with an embodiment of wisdom. Even in places where it should not be given. Even to those to whom it should not be given. Am I the one? These are the general mistakes we commit. Strī, Bala. What is the next one? Andha, blind. Who are these blind people? See, to gain knowledge, you must choose the right instrument. For example, if I have to gain the knowledge of color and form, what is the instrument to be used? Eyes. So this is called as pramana. Right? To get the prama of a prameya, right pramana vyapara has to happen. This is a technical way. Pramata has to use the right pramana, and the right pramana vyapara has to happen to gain the prama of prameya. If you have not understood, you are normal, as I said. The point is only this much. If you want to gain the knowledge of color and form, what is the right instrument? Eyes. So eyes have to be used in the right way, then you gain the knowledge. But suppose you say, no, I don't believe in what the eyes are showing, but I want to see the color of this object. I will use other means, logic, this, that, etc. Will it work? Then such a person is called andha. Andha means what? Blind. Blind means what? The one who is not using the right instrument for gaining that particular knowledge. Whatever knowledge you have to gain in this world, right instrument has to be used. Otherwise you will not gain knowledge. Everything is not about logical arguments and discussion. There are so many things in this world, logics cannot prove it. With logic you try to prove that this apple is of red color. Can you? No. There is only one way, the eyes have to see it as red, that is the proof, full stop. You can't prove the sound through logic. So don't apply logic in the wrong place. There are so many places where the logic will not work, intellect will not work, reasoning will not work. Accept the limitations of the intellect. Reasoning style is perfect. It is a science. We accept it. But in the wrong place, it is the wrong instrument. It is the wrong means of knowledge. Now to get the smell of something, nose alone can do. The organ of smell. Isn't it? In the same way, there are so many things in this world which cannot be perceived by the sense organs. Don't say that unless you prove it to the sense organs, I will not believe. Don't say that. It is as foolish as saying, prove that this object is of this color. Through logic. No, not possible. So therefore we say, Atindriya Vishaye Vedaha Pramanam. Atindriya Vishaye. Regarding the matters which are Atindriya. Atindriya means which is beyond sense perception. So then how to gain that knowledge of such things? Vedaha Pramanam. Vedas, they are the means of knowledge. Swarga, Naraka, etc. Is it there or not? Let us use science to prove it. Science cannot prove it. dharma, adharma, punya, papa exist or not. Scientific investigation is not the way. You are using the wrong means. God exists or not. These are all atindriya vishayam. So there are two atindriya vishayas mainly. Dharma and Brahma. Brahman exists or not. They are atindriya vishayam. Indriyas cannot know it. Dharma. That is also atindriya vishaya. Right. So those people who adopt the wrong means to arrive at truth, they are called andha, blind. Blind people. So here in the modern times, the scientists, they are the andhas. They have the ability to, you know, logically think. All these abilities are there. They are extremely brilliant. You can't say they don't have intelligence. They have. Very sharp intelligence they have. Ability they have. Everything they have. But what is the problem with them? They are andha. They are walking. Body is healthy. They are able to walk also. But eyes are not there. Where are they going then? Blind fellow is walking. Very busy. I am very busy. Don't talk to me. Arey sir, but at least open your eyes. No. You must know where you are going. No, I don't have time to open my eyes. I don't believe in my eyes. Where are you going then? Andha. So those people who don't consider Vedas as Pramanam, they are called as Andha here. They don't have faith in Vedas. They have faith in their own intellectual power, etc. Then they are Andhas, blind. Avidyayam antare vartamanaha swayam dhiraha panditam manyamanaha dandramyamanaha pariyanti mudhaha andhenaiva niyamanaya thandaha. Avidyayam antare vartamanaha. They are where? In avidya. But what do they consider themselves? Swayam dhiraha panditam manyamanaha. I am great. I know everything. I'm a wise man. I know everything. Full of arrogance. Where are they? In avidya. So they never surrender unto a teacher. They never go to any guru. They have no faith in the Vedas. Dandramyamanaha pariyanti mudaha. They are completely lost. They are called as mudaha, foolish people. Andhenaiva niyamanayatha. They are blind and they are promising others, see, you please come with me, I will show you the way. He himself is blind. See the scriptures, beautifully how they say, a person who has not surrendered unto a guru, this verse is all about the glory of guru. Vyamoha samharine. A person who thinks that I will get liberated with, you know, I will reach the truth with my own ability. Such people are called as andha, blind. So what is being criticized here? Our lack of faith in the scriptures, in the teachers, in the guru parampara, in the shastra. See, earlier what was said? Sakshat tattvamasiti vedavachasa. You see? Yo bodhyati ashritan. Vedavachasa. Veda is the pramana. Based on the teachings of the scriptures, you must do your sadhana. Because there are so many ways of wrongly analyzing your experiences and coming to wrong conclusions. It is possible. Just because you are going through various experiences doesn't mean you will be wise. Experiencing various things is not going to make you wise. Experiencing, along with it, analyzing the experience in the light of knowledge, that is what is going to make you wise. Otherwise, we are all going through experiences. If mere experiences are going to make you wise, then all elderly people must be wise. It is not so. Experience must be analyzed correctly in the light of the scriptures. Then that experience contribute to your knowledge, contribute to your wisdom. Andha. The next term we will take in the next class. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschid dukha bhag bhavet. Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityoma amritam gamaya. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.